They say, I don't know who they are, but they say being funny is mankind's greatest blessing, but they don't know what funny people go through. Being labeled as funny, even if you tell something seriously, people don't take it seriously. And do you know when it hurts more than a breakup? When your own parents, your best friend, your fellow Toastmasters don't understand your joke. Other problem is, more often, comedy turns into the tragedy. And hence, to be or not to be funny? That is the question. Good evening, my dear brothers and their sisters. One morning during my school days, my mother was trying to wake me up. She was saying, "Wake up, Akash. Oversleeping is such a waste of time. And they say, time is money." Funny Akash inside me woke up. I said, "Mom, if we wake up late, we can directly have a lunch. And we can say lot of money we spend on breakfast." And I say, "Money is money." She got annoyed. And then she did the trademark trick of Indian moms to wake their kids up. She turned off the fan. As I woke up late, it got late for the school. And my class teacher, with his usual question for me, that is, "Why are you late?" was waiting for me. He was a science teacher and he had regret that India's freedom war ended before he born. But he used to take revenge from British by killing their language with his exceptional grammar and pronunciations. Also, he had a habit of saying "okay" more often. For example, "Today we will start chapter 3, okay? Draw this diagram, okay?" But those who never used to pay attention in any class used to pay attention in this class. They used to count how many times he says "okay." That's why I am a good accounter. That day, he asked me a slightly different question. He asked, "Your fans come on time. Why can't you come with them?" Funny Akash woke up in the morning, was still awake. And in soft voice, I just said, "Munna jhund mein to suar aate, sher akela hi aata." I said, "Mix coming groups, lion comes alone." Just to crack a joke amongst ourselves. But my friends, who are supportive audience, they all started laughing loudly. The teacher asked them, "What did you say?" But the audience was responsible. My responsible audience kept mum in response to the teacher's question. He said to me, "Don't show your smartness here. Next week of this week. There is kiss competition, show your smartness there." And everyone was like, "Huh?" But soon we realized that it was not kiss competition, it was quiz competition. Scolded me for a bit and moved on to teaching. I decided to sit like a very sincere student this lecture, so that he won't scold me more. Today I was not even counting his okays. After some time, my two friends who were sitting with me on same bench started smiling. I asked them, "What happened?" One of them said, "I was imagining you taking part in kiss competition." I said, "And I was imagining you not being allowed to take part." And the teacher noticed us not paying attention. He said, "Both of you, three, stand up." He scolded us like anything and said, "Okay, one of you, tell me the Joule's law." My friend saw towards me with great expectations. And I knew it, because last night I was burning the midnight oil to study the same. I said, "Sir, if the physical state of the conductor remains then the current from the conductor is directly equivalent to the potential difference after it." Total silence. Some girls were whispering, I knew they were praising me. Now I wanted to see teacher's reaction. And he said, "It is not Joule's law, it is Ohm's law, okay?" And then, both of us three, comedy turned into the tragedy. Hashtag being funny since childhood. The other day, I told a friend sitting in my cubicle, "Yeah, was not feeling well, had to go to a doctor this morning." He stopped working, turned towards me and asked, "Okay, then what happened next?" was expecting a joke. People think funny people are never serious. When you are labeled as funny, even if you are on ventilator, few people won't agree that you are serious. The other day I told a girl, nice dress, you look beautiful in it. She did not even say thank you. She went to a friend and asked her, is there anything wrong in this dress? And hence, to be or not to be funny, that is the question. Answer is yes. Because even if comedy turns into the tragedy, it becomes a memory. And other problems of being funny are funny problems. And are nothing before this noble thing called spreading laughter, which is much needed in today's world. Hence, be funny, spread the laughter. Laughter keeps our mind and body healthy. And it saves lot of money we spend for medical bills. Therefore, I say, funny is?
Money.
Money.
Support your audience. By the way, do you know what funny means in Marathi?
Yes.
Funny. Being funny. And when someone is very funny, we say he is too funny. Keep laughing like this, learn to laugh for small reasons, even for no reasons. Keep smiling always. And when you will start doing that, believe me, people will call you mad. Thank you very much. The reason to give this speech was, now you can easily relate to the points I will make with reference to this speech. And it's a proof that people do laugh on my jokes. So now I can expect that you will pay attention to the tips I am going to share. We have allocated some time for your questions in the end. If you get any question, you can ask in the end. You can ask questions or put your points during the session as well. As we are discussing about questions, let me ask you one question. How many of you have this question? How to choose a topic? I know some of you will surely ask this question in the end. So let's start with this point itself. There are three ways I can tell you. One, check if you remember any funny story or incident about you or someone else which you can use to view your screen. And if you have one, view a speech around it. Other ways, if you have a speech or a story that you think can be made funny, you can view your speech from it. Here, you first write your speech and then try to make it funny. You can exaggerate the things little bit to make it funny. And the third way is, which I used, if you have some great jokes of yours and you think you can kill it using them, try to view a speech around them. I wanted to add that Ohm's law incident. Then I thought, why would the teacher ask me the Ohm's law? I wanted him to ask me the Ohm's law. That's why I came late in the school. And I wanted to reach the school late. That's why I woke up late in the school morning. Get it? You can choose a topic or topics using these ways. Once you have a topic or topics, give some time or days to think on it before you start writing on it. It will help you to choose one topic if you have more than one in your mind, and will reduce your efforts to start anew, because you might realize later on that you chose a wrong topic. One important thing here is, you must set a timeline. Till what date you will choose a topic, till what date you will work on script. And once that time comes, you must start preparing for the next thing. Remember, even if you don't choose a good topic, if you write your script well, your topics will look good. And even if you don't write your script well, if you deliver it well, your script will look good. And hence, the priority should be first delivery, second script, and third topic. Now, we have a topic. Now, the next task is, can anyone guess?
Writing
intelligent audience. My next tips are about avoiding common mistakes while writing the script. One thing you should understand that humorous speech is also a speech. In humorous speech contest, you should not do a stand-up comedy. A humorous speech should have all other aspects that a normal speech has, like having a proper opening, body and conclusion, a message if possible. And apart from all other aspects, the speech should be humorous. If you are participating, I would request you to see the judges' ballots once to know more about what are the other aspects you need. Other thing is, don't write on usual topics like Indian marriages. If you have good and unheard content, then there is no harm in writing on usual topics as well. But having unusual topics always helps. Other important thing is, it is not like that if you speak controversial or if you insult someone, then only people laugh. And you will never know what judges might think. So avoid speaking controversial and insulting someone. Also, if you are referring something to create jokes, make sure that at least 75% people know about it. Avoid jokes which only few people can understand. I saw a speech where the contestant was cracking jokes on a Bhojpuri actor and the speech was happening in Pune. He shouldn't have done that. Instead, he should have cracked jokes on any global superstar like Dincha Puja. So these are the things you should keep in mind while writing your script. Now your script is ready. Now the next task is to work on delivery. Remember, pause is a soul of humor. In my speech there was this part. The teacher had regret that India's freedom war ended before he born. But he used to take revenge from British by killing their language. Here a pause is required. If I say like this, but he used to take revenge from British by killing their language, it won't have much effect, right? There is one more pause which is very important for humorous speeches, is a pause after the joke. You should give proper time to audience to understand and to laugh. While going through the video of my area level contest, I found that I am not giving proper time to audience to laugh. And hence the next line, after the joke, sometimes was unheard. At area level, when I said, the students used to count how many times the teacher used to say, okay, people were laughing more than I expected. But I didn't stop much and I said my next line. That is, that's why I'm a good accountant. Many people did not understand that. There was a lady who asked me after the contest, so you are an accountant? So this really happened. So the question that someone may ask in the end is, how to work on pauses? The answer is practice. Remember, a humorous speech needs more practice than a normal speech. And considering pauses and the time we give to audience to understand and to laugh, we should keep our script short to avoid going over time. Now you have worked on delivery as well. Now the next task is, can anyone guess? To deliver on the stage. My next tips are about delivering on the stage. I have seen it happens with many contestants. They start delivering and if they don't get expected response in the beginning, they either get nervous or they start doing overacting. One thing you should understand that only you know what is there in your script. So even if some jokes don't work, you just move on with confidence as if no joke was intended. It is very important to keep calm on the stage throughout the speech for humorous speeches. It happened with me at division level. For first 1 minute, I did not get expected response. But I didn't panic because I knew that my main jokes are yet to come. If you keep calm, you can handle audience's responses. Sometimes you may get more laughter than expected. Sometimes you may not get laughter at all. And also, if you keep calm, you will be able to do last minute changes if possible, if required. What happened at district level is, in my speech there was this part that I was not listening to my mother, she was trying to wake me up. And then she does the trademark trick of Indian moms to wake their kids up, she turns off the fan. At district level, one of the contestants told the same idea before me. Then how I handled it is, I said, after telling that my mother was trying to wake me up and I was not listening to her, I said, now my next line was, then she turned off the fan. But Toastmaster Shrikar has already mentioned that idea. Today I found a new problem of being funny. That is, someone else might tell the similar joke before you. And audience just loved that part. Now the question that someone may ask in the end is, how to keep calm? What I do for that is, I generally don't leave any preparation for the last day. And during the contest, I do talk with people around normally, which helps me to be in good mood. And hence I enjoy being on the stage. And the last tip which I am going to share is, all such tips, including this one, are just suggestions and not compulsions. You will get many suggestions and feedback from many people. You have to decide whether they are appropriate for your script and, more importantly, your style of delivery. There is saying in Marathi, Aikave janache karave manache. Get suggestions from others and choose some of them wisely. If you are confident about someone, something, don't change it only because someone is asking you to do so. That doesn't mean we should not take feedback. Feedback are necessary, both in speeches and in life. Just avoid confusion. When in confusion, decide on what suits to your style of delivery. To summarize, the first point, I told you how to choose a topic. I told you three ways. One, weave a speech from a funny story or incident you have. Two, weave a speech from a story or a speech you think can be made funny. And three, weave a speech from jokes you have. The second tip was avoiding common mistakes while writing the script. One, avoid usual topics and speaking controversial. Two, avoid jokes which only few people can understand. And three, humorous speech is also a speech. The third tip was work on pauses, practice more, and give proper time to audience to understand and to laugh. And considering pauses and the time we give to audience to understand and to laugh, we should keep our script shorter. Fourth tip was be calm and keep yourself relaxed. And for that, don't leave any preparation for the last day, and during the contest, do talk with people around normally. And the last tip was, do take feedback and suggestions, just avoid confusion. When in confusion, decide on what suits to your style of delivery. I have tried to answer few possible questions in the session. Feel free to ask any other question you have.
So, one of my problems is, once I start writing a speech, it sounds funny to me, but I don't know whether it is really funny or not. And many times in that confusion, I lose out on good content. Sometimes I add a bad content thinking that this is what people might find funny. So how do we get that?
I also had doubt about this point, whether people will laugh on my jokes or not. So I tried those jokes with my friends. Like, I told this incident as if it was happened really. Or you can give your speech to your mentor or in your club to check whether jokes are working or not. So we have to try on others because we cannot think from their perspective. So I do check my jokes on others. So always I have tried all these other jokes which were there in my speech before this contest.
Okay, so
yes.
Humorous contest, you know, it's always to be funny, or little funniness and some message to the society or something can be included in such contest.
It should be a balance of both. Mm-hmm. It should have all other aspects, as I told you, like normal speech. It should have proper body, opening, conclusion, a message, some other points like stage movement, body language, voice modulation, grammar, English. Apart from that, it should be humorous. There are few points for humorous thing. So in judges ballot, there is properly given that for which point, how much points are there. So you should see on the internet.
So yeah. Is message very important, or can it be avoided? Just if you have a structure without having a very solid message.
Speech can be informative as well, no message. But I found that speeches with message gets more marks maybe.
Okay. In general, in contests, since we have various different contestants contesting for the event, there is always a risk of maybe kind of a joke we are going to crack may not be content, but a similar nature has been already been repeated. In fact, one of the incidents you mentioned. So while we prepare, like, is it better to be ready with a plan B, or more focus should be on the delivery part of it?
Yes, it is always better to be ready. You should think about every joke, that what will I say if this happens. I didn't prepare, so luckily I saved there, but I think I should have prepared well in advance for each joke.
When we crack joke during the speech, should we also laugh with the audience, or we just have to?
No, you should control your emotions. If you laugh, people won't laugh on your next joke. You should show that seriousness. And when we are taking jokes on ourselves, like I was in trouble, I was getting scolded by teacher, you should not laugh. You should show that seriousness that I was in the receiving area.
In your speech, it was a how do you say it? More of a one-dimensional speech, less of conversation, more of narration.
Yes.
So, what do you suggest? I mean, what since you have been at district and then you are also one there. So, what kind of style works best generally? I mean, having exaggerations or these conversations, do they work?
No, the style which will work is which is your strength. If your strength is narration, you should go by that. So, you should give your best. It is not like that for a particular thing, because I have seen many winning speeches on YouTube. So everyone has his or her own style, they deliver it differently. So whatever is your strength, you do go by that. I generally don't feel comfortable by having conversations like the students said, the teachers, I don't feel comfortable. So what is my strength is telling jokes one by one, so I follow that. So as I told you, you know which are your strengths and what you can deliver better. So go by your instinct. Thank you. I urge you to participate in the coming contest in large numbers. Believe me, it's not tough to give a humorous speech. And as I said, spreading laughter is a noble thing. You should try. Thank you.